Hindi. Today's virtual assembly is conducted by the students of Standard 9B. Prayer is the world's wireless connection towards God, which gives everyone a fresh day. So let's start with a prayer song sung by Mithika Jijish.
Logam muluvan sukham pagaranai sneha deepame miritu rakko. Logam muluvan sukham pagaranai sneha deepame miritu rakko. Kadana nivarana kalivin nurave kaattin naduvil vali telikku. Logam muluvan sukham pagaranai sneha deepame miritu rakko.
As we all are going through a tough time, we should pray for our world in order to overcome the situation. So let's pray along with Fella Anish.
Heavenly Father, from the depths of our pain and confusion, we cry out to you with fearful hearts and anxious minds. We plead to you, rescue us from this pandemic. Father of compassion and grace, we lift up our eyes to you. We cry out for your healing and needed resources. We offer before you all the medical professionals and caretakers attending to those infected with the virus. Lord, have mercy on us. Amen.
Today, July 27th, the death anniversary of our former president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Let's hear more about Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam from Pavana Project.
Respected Headmistress Revna Sister Lina, teachers and all my dear friends, a warm good morning to one and all. Today, July 27th is observed as the death anniversary of our beloved missile man of India. Yes, it's none other than APJ Abdul Kalam. Now, I'm here to speak about this philanthropist APJ. APJ Abdul Kalam was an aerospace scientist and a phenomenal teacher who served as the 11th President of India from 2002 to 2007, widely referred as People's President. He proved with his 5 years tenure what he said a leader should be. A leader must have a vision for his organization, passion to work for achieving goal, curiosity to travel an unexplored path, and courage to take decision. Kalam was born in 1931, the son of a little educated boat owner in an island town, Rameshwaram, in the erstwhile Madras state. His birth anniversary is observed as World Students Day. Kalam was noted for his integrity and simple lifestyle. Religion and spirituality were very important for him throughout his life. He had an unparalleled career as a defense scientist, culminating in the highest civilian award of India, Bharat Ratna. As the chief of the country's defense research and development programmer, Kalam demonstrated a great potential for dynamics and innovations that existed in seemingly moribund research organization. He played a major role in the development of India's missiles and nuclear weapon program. It was his hard work and effort for over a decade that made it possible for a country, India, to have its first indigenous SLV. Till then, it was less than a dream for us to have our own satellite launch vehicle. SLV-3 was developed by Kalam and it marked India's entry into the space club. It was Kalam who took the responsibility for the development of indigenous guided missiles at the Defense Research and Development Organization. Kalam was nicknamed as the Missile Man of India, as he was the pre-head of Agni and Prithvi missiles. A lot of achievements are there to be listed out, but time won't permit me to do so. On July 27, 2015, while delivering a lecture in the Indian Institute of Management, Shillong, Kalam collapsed and passed away with an apparent cardiac arrest. Dream is not which we see while sleeping. It's something which does not let us sleep. With this famous quote of APJ Abdul Kalam, I'm concluding my words. Thank you and have an auspicious day.
Good and inspiring thought can spice a party. Hearing new thought will keep us smiling and engaging. So, here's Niswana with thought for the day.
One day, as APJ was in a hurry, he stepped into the wrong class, where his maths teacher was taking a class. He glared at APJ through his glasses and said, "What are you doing in the school? If you can't even find the right way to the class, you should go back to the village where you came from." He then caught APJ by the scruff of his neck and caned him in front of the whole class. He felt crushed. His family had made great sacrifices to send him to the school. He felt terribly homesick at times, but he was determined to make his family proud. From that day on, he made up his mind not only to be a good student, but to be the best. He studied night and day. Many months later, his dream of scoring full marks in his math exam finally came true. He was thrilled. The next morning, during their assembly, the same teacher who had punished him earlier stood up, smiled and said, "Whoever I punish becomes a great man." Everyone in the assembly burst out laughing. He then recounted what had happened. He pointed to APJ and added, "Mark my words, this boy is going to bring glory to his school and teachers."
APJ Abdul Kalam, a well-determined person, he when he came from a poor family, his determination to become a powerful man became true as he achieved the place of Indian president. Moreover, he was the missile man of India. Determination is the main thing that we learn from his life. "Failure will never overtake me if my determination to succeed is strong enough. I repeat, failure will never overtake me if my determination to succeed is strong enough." These are the words of APJ Abdul Kalam.
Poetry is a way of expressing our feelings. So, here is Lakshmi Krishna Kumar with her own poem about Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam.
Morning friends. നമ്മുടെ രാഷ്ട്രപതി ആയിരുന്ന APJ അബ്ദുൽ കലാമിനെ കുറിച്ചുള്ള ഒരു കവിതയാണ് ഞാനിവിടെ ചൊല്ലാൻ പോകുന്നത്. വാനിലുയർന്ന അഗ്നിച്ചിറകുകൾ. സ്വപ്ന ചിറകുകൾ വിരിച്ച് ഉയരാൻ പഠിപ്പിച്ച നക്ഷത്രമേ, നിനക്കു പ്രണാമം. രാമേശ്വരത്തുനിച്ചൊരു നക്ഷത്രമേ നീ, ജ്വലിക്കുന്ന സൂര്യനായി മാറി ജീവിതയാത്രയിലുടനീളം. കയ്യൊപ്പു പതിപ്പിക്കാൻ മറന്നില്ല സ്വപ്നങ്ങൾക്കപ്പുറമുള്ളൊരു ലോകത്തേക്കായി. റോക്കറ്റായി പറന്നുയരാൻ പഠിപ്പിച്ചു നീ. നീ പാറിച്ചൊരാ അഗ്നിയാകാശഗംഗയിൽ ഭാരതത്തിനൊരഭിമാനമായി. ധന്യമീ ജീവിതയാത്രയിലുടനീളം. അറിവിൻ്റെ അഗ്നിയായി പെയ്തിറങ്ങി നീ. അഗ്നിച്ചിറകുകൾ അറ്റുനീ പോലും ഒരായിരം തലമുറകൾ കഴിഞ്ഞാലും നിൻ അഗ്നിജ്വാല അണയുകിൽ ഒരിക്കലും." നന്ദി.
Our beloved headmistress, Sister Lina, is here with a message for you all.
Good morning, my dear children and teachers. How are you all? Hope that all are keeping fine and safe at home. Dear children, I would like to share a small thought with you in this fine morning. To succeed in life, you must have single-minded devotion to your goal. It's a famous quote by APJ Abdul Kalam. When he says this, this thought or this quote is very much actualized in his life. We all are well aware of the life of APJ Abdul Kalam. Being in an ordinary family, as he was having his goal set from the very childhood onwards, he could succeed in his life. It is written in his life history. While he was going back from school to home, he used to spend some time along with his friends near the pond. When all were engaged in playing with pebbles in the water, he used to look at the sky and wonder how the cranes and seagulls are flying high. That was a motivation for him to set his goal. Later, when he grew up, he thought of setting a goal and he realized that he has to go for engineering. And we know, as he had to go for his higher studies in a prestigious institution, he had to get a scholarship. And while preparing to get the scholarship, it is said in his book, he hardly slept 1 hour during night because he had lots of work to complete his project. But later, when he got the scholarship, his happiness was something extreme. Dear children, when we set goal and when we have dreams in life, only we will be able to succeed. So Abdul Kalam's life teaches us that we have to have the goal in front of us and take one step each day to achieve that goal. You are being in a very different situation now doing your learning, but always remember, set goals and have dreams in your life. You will be able to follow your dreams and achieve your goals. I pray for that and may God bless you all the very best to you. Thank you.
Sketches of an artist depicts their liking for it. This is a sketch of Kirtana Pramod. She had handed over the same to our beloved headmistress, Sister Lina.
Now, here is Stefana Mohammed with the review of the book, The Wings of Fire, written by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Stefana of 9B. I'm here to speak about the book, Wings of Fire, written by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, former Honorable President of India. It is an account of a young boy who tries to achieve all his dream, beating all odds. This book shows countless effort of our scientists in achieving superiority in aeronautical space and rocket technology. This book stresses on the point that we should not get disheartened by failures. The book gives messages that we should not walk the life due to setbacks. It is a must read because it is a proof that determination can help you to achieve your goals. Thank you.
As you all know, we are fighting against COVID-19. Here is Haya Bindali with some tips for the present situation.
Good morning. Today, I am here to tell you some precautions against the pandemic COVID-19. As you all know, we have to maintain a personal hygiene. And the most important thing is, we have to take in immunity boosters, especially green leafy vegetables and fruits that contain vitamin C and D. Taking a lot of water as possible and other oral fluids. Above all, whoever you come across, whether it's your cousins, friends or relatives, consider them as COVID positive and maintain a safe distance from them. This is one of the most important safety measures to prevent the spread. If your area is under the containment zone, follow the advice provided by your local health authorities. Don't ever forget to wear on your masks and use sanitizers. engaged in physical and mental activities to give relaxation for your body. Because of the pandemic diseases being over, the availability for the masks and sanitizers are low. So I'm going to show you how to make masks and sanitizers in homes.
How to make sanitizers in our home. So first of all, I'm going to take aloe vera. So I'm taking two pieces of aloe vera. Now we'll peel off this. So I'm cutting off the aloe vera skin. Then we'll take the gel. So now we'll take the aloe vera gel from this aloe vera. So aloe vera is the main ingredient in this. So we'll peel off the aloe vera. So with the hands, just make this into a gel. This aloe vera into a smooth thing. Now I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of rubbed alcohol into it. This now by adding the rubbed alcohol, mix it many times. Now I'm gonna add rose water so I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of rose water. Now we'll mix it again. That should be a very good mixture. Now the mixture is ready here. Now we have to transfer this into bottle. So we'll see. So I'm taking this bottle for the sanitizer. So now we'll add this sanitizer to this bottle. So now I have shifted this sanitizer into this bottle. Now we'll shake it goodly, very well. Now our homemade sanitizer is ready here. Now we'll test. How to make masks out of kerchief and rubber bands. For that, first we have to fold the masks into 3, that is length and width should be same. Now I fold the kerchief. Now we'll put on the rubber bands in both the sides. Now these two sides should be equal. Now we'll fold this. The other one, we have to tug in inside this one so it will stand correctly. Now we'll see, our masks are ready. Now we'll see how it fits on us.
Every scotton has a lid. Before we wind up, on behalf of my classmates, I thank everyone who helped us making this virtual SLP, especially our headmistress, Sister Lena, our beloved class teacher, Ms. Sheeja, Mrs. Anita, and Mrs. Kairali. So guys, stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Have a nice day.